In the introduction of Great Expectations, 7-year-old Pip, the protagonist, looks over the graves of his parents in a cemetery on the marshes, where he meets an escaped convict who terrifies Pip and orders the boy to bring him food and a file. Pip lives with his older sister, Mrs. Joe, and her husband, Joe, a blacksmith. Pip aids the convict, and the following day, Pip and Joe tag along with soldiers searching for two missing convicts, Magwitch and Compasson, who were rearrested. A wealthy, reclusive woman named Miss Havisham sends for Pip to visit her. Miss Havisham is decrepit-looking, wearing a faded wedding dress. Pip plays cards with Estella, Havisham's adopted daughter, who insults him. During the rising action, Pip then begins to visit Miss Havisham on a regular basis. Pip becomes infatuated with Estella, but sees himself as her inferior. Pip becomes Joe's apprentice, but is ashamed of his work. One day, Miss Havisham tells Pip that his services are no longer required. Pip develops a desire to become a gentleman. Attacked by an unidentified assailant, Mrs. Joe loses her ability to speak. A young woman named Biddy comes to nurse Mrs. Joe. After several years, a visiting lawyer named Mr. Jaggers tells Joe and Pip that an anonymous benefactor wants to pay for Pip to be educated as a gentleman. Pip assumes it's Miss Havisham. Pip heads to London and stays with a young man named Herbert Pocket, who explains how Miss Havisham was jilted by her lover on her wedding day and has since remained a recluse. Pip is tutored by Matthew Pocket, Herbert's father. Pip becomes friends with Jaggers' clerk, Wemmick. Pip acts and lives like a gentleman, uncomfortable about the crude manner Joe visiting him. Pip again visits Miss Havisham and sees Estella, who is now a beautiful lady. Mrs. Joe dies and Pip briefly returns to attend the funeral at Joe's house. On Pip's 21st birthday, Mr. Jaggers tells Pip he will now receive the funds his anonymous benefactor promised. 2 years later, Magwitch tells a shocked Pip that he is Pip's benefactor. Feeling he owes Magwitch a great deal, but also ashamed of him, Pip plans to leave the country with him. Visiting Miss Havisham and Estella, Pip realizes that Estella plans to marry the brutish Bentley Drummle, which breaks his heart. Estella marries Drummle, and Pip learns Magwitch is her father. Pip visits Miss Havisham, who begs Pip to forgive her. After this plea, Miss Havisham's dress catches fire, and Pip puts out the flames. In the climax of the novel, Pip and Magwitch attempt to flee the country in a boat, but fail when they're intercepted by a boat containing authorities and Compasson. Magwitch is severely injured. Because Magwitch has no official heirs, his fortune does not go to Pip, but instead goes to the government. During the falling action, Pip tells Magwitch that his daughter is alive and that Pip loves her. Grateful to hear this news, Magwitch dies. Pip falls ill and is nursed back to health by Joe. Pip visits Joe at his home and realizes that it's on Joe and Biddy's wedding day. Pip renews his friendship with Joe. In the resolution, Pip and Estella show signs of getting together. But in Dickens' original ending, Pip and Estella reconcile, but then part.